problem is to write a program in Python to count the occurrence of an item in a list. Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to WS Cube Tech. My name is Ayushi Jain, and in this video we will learn how to write a program that will allow us to count how many times a number or a value is occurring inside the list. For this method, first of all, we need to know what are lists. Lists are a data type in Python that allows us to store multiple data types inside. They are enclosed inside the square brackets. Each value inside the list is separated by a commas, right? Okay, now what do we need to do over here is that if we have a list, we need to count how many times any particular item is occurring inside that list. Let's have a look on how it can be done in Python. For this, first of all, I'll be creating a list called as numbers. And inside this, I'll be adding some numbers to the list. So I'll be writing 10, 30, 20, 10, 40, 20, 10, 40, 10, 20, then 10. Okay. So what do I need to do is I need to find that suppose this list is right now very small, right? But what if this list was a huge list? And in that case, if I wanted to find that how many times element 10 is occurring in this list, for that we have a very simple method. I'll be writing count underscore occurrence. This is just a variable. You can give it any name over here. So you can just write, if you want to write any short name, you can write a short name. Or if you want to write a count occurrence just like me, then you can write count occurrence as well. After this, what do we need to do is we need to write the name of our list, that is numbers dot count. The first method over here is count. And what do we need to count? We need to count number 10, then how many times number 10 is occurring. And then we'll print count occurrence. Let's run and see what output we'll get. So as soon as I run it, I'll get the output 4, that 4 times element 10 is occurring, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4, which is correct as well. Similarly, if I wanted to check it for number 40, not 140, but 40, in that case, it would have given us 2 times. Suppose if I would have written any number that is not there inside this list, suppose 50 is not there inside the list, which is actually not there. And if I run it, it would give me the output 0, that it is not occurring at all inside our list. So I hope guys the method is clear over here that first of all you need to create a list in which you can add any element. Suppose if they were strings, suppose if instead of numbers they were a comma l comma a comma w comma c comma b comma w. So what do I need to check in this time? I want to check that how many times alphabet w is occurring. For that I'll be creating a string over here as well and I'll be writing w. And if as soon as I run it, I'll get the output that one time W is occurring. Why? Because here we have not put the comma. Now again, if I run it, I'll be getting the output as 2. So again, if I run it, I'll be getting the output as 2 over here. And if I check it for alphabet C, it would give me 1 as an output because one time, only one time alphabet C is occurring. So I hope guys that the method is clear to you. All you need to do is write the name of the list followed by dot count function, which will count whatever element you want to count inside the list. So I hope you guys have no doubts in the questions, and for more such interesting programs, stay connected guys. Thank you.